We will now begin the Northeastern University College of Professional Studies doctoral hooding and graduation ceremony. The procession of graduates will now begin. We ask all to please rise as you are able for the procession of the platform party. We invite you to be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, David Madigan.
Thank you very much. I'm extremely happy to be here. It's a very happy occasion. Congratulations to all of you. Welcome, graduates, families, friends, faculty, and staff. It's just, despite the weather outside, to be able to have events like this is just spectacular. And you know that you made it here today, having lived through the last, whatever it is, year and a half, it's more than a year and a half now. It's just a tremendous recognition of your hard work, the sacrifices you made, your dedication to getting to this day. Congratulations, graduates. Your families and friends seated behind probably had a lot to do with this as well. So please take this occasion, graduates, to, if you will, stand and turn and thank your families and friends. Completing a doctor is a spectacular achievement. It requires years of dedication, and you have done it under truly extraordinary circumstances. I can't even imagine having done one myself at a point in my life. It's an amazing accomplishment. It's such a huge amount of work to get it over the finish line and to get to this point. I didn't have to face a pandemic when I was doing mine. You did, so yeah, it's just amazing. We're very proud of you. You represent the strength and the breadth of the Northeastern Knowledge Network. This university is all about impact, having impact in the world, which we do directly through the work that we do at this university, and of course, vicariously through our learners. And we, you represent our promise to the world to be change agents. You're going to go out into the world equipped with a doctorate from Northeastern, and we have every expectation that you will indeed have many impacts, positive impacts on this world. We invite you to draw on the Northeastern Network. This is a community that spans the globe and will always be a resource for you. We have alumni, I don't know if we have alumni in every country in the world, but we certainly have alumni all over the world. We also have physical locations in different parts of the world that I hope you will visit and come to events at our locations throughout North America, in London, and presumably in future locations in the years to come. The power of what you have accomplished is incredible, moments like today are just so special in the life of this of any university, but it's certainly special in the life of our university. Your shared understanding and shared experience you are the future in terms of getting this world to a better place. We face some extraordinary challenges related to climate, related to systemic racism, related to hunger and poverty in the world. I have great optimism that you and the Northeastern alums to come will have profound impacts in improving the world. We're very proud of what you have done. Congratulations. Well done. And now I'd like to welcome the Dean of the College of Professional Studies, David Fields, to come to the podium. Thank you.
Thank you, Provost Madigan. On behalf of the faculty and staff of the College of Professional Studies, I join you in welcoming everyone to this exceptional day. Students, family, and friends, I want you to know that the doctoral degree holds a very special place in our mission-driven college, especially these last 20 months or so, as our lives have been totally upended by a global pandemic, and your ingenuity and resilience have shown through. As our mission will tell you, Northeastern's College of Professional Studies exists in order to unleash the capacities of aspiring individuals in all stages and walks of life. We are here to break down boundaries between work and learning and focus on impact in every community we touch. We support a growing global network of students, faculty, alumni, and employers with philanthropic partners who together develop apply and share practical wisdom informed by the deep resources of the research university and service of causes much larger than ourselves. The professional doctorates conferred by our college exemplify this mission. This is why the symbolism of the hooding ceremony at our doctoral commencement honors both the doctoral candidate's work and the network of relationships that make that work possible. The centerpiece of the doctoral degree is the dissertation and research undertaken by the doctoral student under the direction of a faculty member. This relationship is demanding on both sides. Our doctoral students are already full-time professionals and leaders in their fields. In true Northeastern fashion, they are researching what they live and living what they research every day. Their faculty directors are the accomplished scholar practitioners that our doctoral students aspire to be. Dissertation directors invest themselves in the success of their students through hours and years of mentorship and through hundreds of pages of chapter drafts ahead of final dissertation defense. So this demanding relationship comes with its own unique symbolism. At graduation, doctoral students traditionally have their hoods of their academic regalia placed over their heads by the faculty. The symbolism of hooding embodies both humility and pride on both sides of the relationship as faculty members welcome a new peer into their community. Your graduation faculty speaker today is a distinguished member of Northeastern's academic community. Dr. Lindsay Portnoy is a cognitive scientist and associate teaching professor in the Curriculum, Teaching, Learning, and Leadership concentration in the Doctor of Education program. Her research focuses on the use of immersive technologies and systems thinking to enhance cognition and create a more equitable and authentic system of education. She is a former public school teacher and co-founder of the learning games company Killer Snails, which received funding from both the Institute of Education Sciences and National Science Foundation. Dr. Portnoy has been published in academic journals and popular media such as the Washington Post, and she's the author of two books, Designed to Learn, Using Design Thinking to Bring Purpose and Passion to the Classroom, and Game On, Brain On, The Surprising Relationship Between Play and Gray. Her teaching and research have led to such varied experiences as earning a Small Business Innovation Research Award of the Year from the U.S. Small Business Administration and serving on the World Economic Forum's Expert Network. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Lindsay Portnoy.
Thank you, Dean Fields. And thank you for the great honor of welcoming and congratulating Northeastern University's newest professional doctorates. Professional doctorates on behalf of the Doctor of Education, Doctor of Physical Therapy, and Doctor of Law and Policy programs. What a privilege it is to stand alongside you in person today and celebrate what can only be described as a remarkable journey, conducting transformative research to change the world as part of your doctoral program achieved during a global pandemic. Fellow faculty and staff members, please rise and join me in giving our graduates a round of applause. Thank you. Doctors. Please take a moment to acknowledge the sheer magnitude of this experience because it really is nothing short of extraordinary. And as I was thinking about how to welcome such an esteemed group of scholar practitioners, it struck me how well aligned the science of learning is to our globally connected ecosystem of change agents here at Northeastern University. You know, the science of learning centers on the way each of our lived experiences shapes the entirety of our human experience. And so while we are each very literally standing on the shoulders of others, their learning, their accomplishments, their losses, and their triumphs, so too are we constantly changing as a result of our experiences in the world. In my research and writing about cognitive science, I liken design thinking to a flexible framework for more purposeful learning across interdisciplinary systems of knowledge. You know, there's no single set pathway to follow, but really a myriad of tools to use along your journey that deepens your expertise, encourages more inclusivity through divergent thinking, and taps into greater creativity and deeper wells of empathy. So just as new neural networks map novel pathways in our minds, so too have your doctoral studies mapped emergent networks in your lives. And it really is my greatest hope that we can take heed in Dr. Maya Angelou's words of change when she shares that we delight in the beauty of the butterfly, but we rarely admit the changes it has gone through to achieve that beauty. Those changes, those new pathways in our minds, and those activated across our globally networked community are marked by great effort, as you well know. Great effort, great sacrifice, and they come with an even greater expectation if we aspire to truly transformative, successful, more just, and sustainable change. So to borrow from a beloved Emerson poem about what success looks like, actualize, I wanted to share with you today that we learn success is, quote, to laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, to learn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty, to find the best in others, to leave the world a little better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition, to know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived, this is to have succeeded. So while you continue along your already rich professional journeys, equipped with novel tools and connections across the globe as a result of this extraordinary accomplishment, my hope for you is that you consistently strive towards this definition of success, the one that sees each of us as interconnected and therefore interdependent in our shared work towards creating a more inclusive, just, and sustainable future. All the while knowing that while the changes we go through to achieve such beauty may at times be challenging, but in the end, we will leave the world a little better by our efforts. So congratulations, doctors. On behalf of your faculty and staff, we wish you every success as you continue to change the world through your work. And we are certain that you will represent Northeastern University well as you continue to transform our world for the better. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Portnoy. I now invite David Fields, Dean of the College of Professional Studies, to the podium.
The degrees in course will now be conferred. I ask the doctoral candidates and graduates of the Doctor of Physical Therapy, Doctor of Law and Policy, or Doctor of Education to please rise. Provost Madigan, it is my privilege to report to you that the candidates here assembled and others have qualified in all respects for the degrees in course. They have successfully completed curricula offered by the College of Professional Studies at Northeastern University and have been recommended by the faculty and the Council of Deans to be awarded appropriate degrees in recognition of their academic accomplishments. After the candidates have been presented, members of the graduating class will please remain standing until their degrees have been conferred. Provost Madigan, I have the privilege of presenting those candidates. Apologies.
I think we're good.
Yeah. This is my favorite bit. Dean Fields, by virtue of the authority of the Board of Trustees of the University, I confer on you and those who have properly qualified the degree of Doctor of Physical Therapy, Doctor of Law and Policy, or Doctor of Education, according to the curriculum in which you have qualified, with all the honors, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto pertaining. Congratulations.
Will the graduates now please be seated?
Thank you, Provost Madigan and Dean Fields. The faculty marshals will now present the graduates for hooding. I would like to invite Dr. Fiona Creed, Associate Teaching Professor, to introduce the Doctor of Law and Policy graduates.
Hello, I invite Dr. Megan Kennedy, Assistant Teaching Professor, to the stage.
Jasmine Mani Contreras. Surgeon's perception regarding relationship with industry, a qualitative study of nonprofit hospitals. Corey James Eichner, local equitable funding reform in education, a Washington State case study. Elizabeth Macaro Horn, spend perceptions of energy subgrantee recipients of ARRA stimulus funding, cost effectiveness of subgrantee ARRA stimulus funding expenditure. Congratulations. Sharon M. Payne, Judging Justice, a case study of the safety and operational impact of reduced funding to the Connecticut judiciary and its effect on the administration of justice. Congratulations, Sharon. Elizabeth Ann Reedford, Who Do You Think I Am? A qualitative study on how professional and cultural experience of adjudicators affect perceptions of asylum seekers. Donald Patrick Scott, a qualitative study exploring police militarization effect on the police community relationship. Paul B. Thompson, Pandemic Preparedness Policy Paradigm Protocol Prescription, a case study of the lived experiences of senior health security policy officials. Congratulations. Well done. Anthony Warmack, Examining the Impact of Public Act 1240 on University Level Remedial Education in Connecticut. Thank you. I would now like to invite Dr. Adam Thomas, Associate Clinical Professor and Faculty Director, to introduce the following Doctor of Physical Therapy graduates.
Galia Dabe Fishman, Pediatric Physical Therapy Telehealth Lessons from the Field. Marius Firmanek, Effects of Sensory Feedback and Collider Size on Reach to Grasp Coordination in Haptic-Free Virtual Reality. Andreas Procopiu, The Effect of Mindfulness on Chronic Musculoskeletal Pain. Rendlin Anquan Tan, The Effect of Task-Specific Training and Motor Learning Approaches in the Physical Therapy Management of a Child with Wittevine-Kolk Syndrome, a case report. Congratulations. Okay. I would like to now invite Dr. Sarah Ewell, Teaching Professor and Faculty Director at the Graduate School of Education, to introduce the following Doctor of Education graduates.
I would now like to invite Dr. Lindsay Portnoy to the stage to hood the following graduates. Suzanne Rebecca Dunn. Self-determination and its relationship to intrinsic motivation in novice middle school teachers. Shannon Joseph Fairley Pittman, understanding the motivation behind the success of first-generation students. Megan Irene Hutchinson, metacognition and writing instruction, how educators perceive strategy support for students with language-based learning disabilities. Beth Laux, from process to practice, using narrative inquiry to understand how faculty integrate intercultural learning into undergraduate education abroad courses. Lauren Catherine Powchek, development of cultural agility in high-achieving emerging adults, the evaluation of a short-term study abroad experience. Rachel Toncelli, engaging self, story, and community to disrupt cultural deficit thinking, a post-structural narrative inquiry of teacher experience in TESOL preparation. I would now like to invite Dr. Chris Unger to the stage to hood the following graduates. Rowena Thomas Carlos, developing best practices to ensure that students gain context-based skills and knowledge in work-based learning opportunities. Jacqueline Gervais, teachers' perceptions and experiences with critical literacy. Suzette Julian, a narrative study exploring how women of color leaders meaning-making shape their professional and personal experiences in K-12 international schools. Emily Angela Leanne, garnering respect starts from within, supporting leaders in early childhood education. Cornelia Alicia Meeks, cracking the stained glass ceiling, leadership experiences of Black clergywomen in the Black church. Michael Robert Moore, inclusive access course materials, the impact on student outcomes. Heather Mary Sherman, cultivating social and emotional skills in adolescence in relation to first-year college student success. Nicole Marie Willard, Join the Club, an action research study about a virtual professional development book club. Melissa Maureen Renchi, STEM-focused youth leadership and entrepreneurship. I would now like to invite Dr. Corliss Thompson to the stage to hood the following graduates. Gertrude Louise Denton, teacher capacity to adopt and use student-centered instruction in secondary math classrooms.
Congratulations.
Gina DiMaggio, creating positive teacher morale through the teacher evaluation process, an IPA analysis of teacher evaluation in a public New Jersey high school.
Congratulations.
Joelle Sean Ahmad Livingston, teacher struggles, buy-in, and grade level inconsistencies, teachers and administrators' perceptions on restorative justice implementation. Congratulations. Abby Marie Muzzarose, The Pursuit of Excellence, a narrative study exploring the life stories of student affairs positive leaders. Congratulations. Michael A. Ermanetta, an action research study of first-generation college student persistence at a mid-sized private institution in the Northeast. Catherine Potter Bell, strategic inquiry for improving learning and teaching in an interprofessional education program. Jolynn Brand, an interpretive phenomenological analysis of first-generation student experiences in living learning communities at a large public university. Ulrike Bronz, foreign language program implementation at the elementary level. Elizabeth Ann Cacavella, mathematics teachers' perceptions of conceptually based teaching after participation in hackathon style professional development. Christopher Andrew Collins, lateral transfer students, what drives their decision to leave, and why do they experience transfer shock? Kimberly E. Crowley, improving the delivery of teaching and learning for students with autism spectrum disorders. Jillian Kate Dunn, compete or complete, understanding and utilizing student athletes' motivation to graduate from college. Michelle Elise Eckler, the qualities of effective teachers in secondary schools in an urban Connecticut town. Matthew James Murray, exploring the efficacy of mindfulness on regulating the emotional state of middle school students during the high-stakes testing era. I would now like to invite Dr. Corliss Thompson, CPS Special Assistant to the Dean for Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion, Assistant Dean, and Teaching Professor to introduce the following graduates.
Wendy Espinoza Cata, Crisis Leadership, a Narrative Research Study. Oh, we forgot to pull up the person. I'm so sorry. Too many things going on. Let's invite Dr. Michael Dean to the stage. Dr. Michael Dean. Sorry, Mike. All right, now that we have the professor at the stage, now I would like to congratulate Wendy Espinoza Cata, Crisis Leadership, a Narrative Research Study Examining K-12 School Leaders' Sense-Making Amid the 2020 Disruptive Landscape. I'm sorry. Zachary Adam Fine, Examining Second-Year College Student Self-Efficacy Regarding Study Skills, a Qualitative Study. Danielle Hughes, Entrepreneurial Opportunity Alertness in Small Business, a Narrative Research Study Exploring Established Small Business Founders' Experience with Opportunity Alertness in Evolving Economic Landscape. Congratulations. Congrats, Danielle. John Patrick Muldoon, Educational Resiliency in the Era of COVID-19. Amanda Burns Packard, Managing Emotions, Teachers' Use of Emotional Intelligence. Lindsay Ryder, Entrepreneurial Educators, a Narrative Study Examining Professional Transition Experiences of Educators Who Have Experimented with the Launching of an Educational Activity. I would now like to invite Dr. Joan Giblin to the stage. Trevira Boatwright, The Impact of College Element Embedded in a High Quality After School Program. Sarah Ann Buckley, Understanding the Literacy Experiences of Ninth Grade Students at an Urban High School. Angela Michelle DeWicke, Understanding Graduate Experiences with a Simulator-Based Ship Handling Course Series. Nicole Kamisis, Moving Beyond Teaching to the Test, Policy Implementation and the Influence on Teaching Biology. Karen Gwen Pearson, Teaching Visual Art with the Brain in Mind. Christina Lee Nguyen, How Community College Managers Assess Readiness of Technical Employees Transitioning into Middle Management, an Exploratory Case Study. I would like to now invite Dr. Kelly Kahn to the stage. Neil Charles Oliva, Cyberbullying and Gender, a Qualitative Study of How Middle School Girls Experience Cyberbullying. Nathan Horton, Police Officer Meaning Making Through the Decision to Transfer, an IPA study which explores the lived experiences of police officer turnover. Catherine Whitfield Lavender, staff experiences with the organizational departure of Chief Student Affairs Officers, an interpretative phenomenological analysis. Adora Ndidi Maka Otiji Spisler, cross-generational collaboration in the workplace, a study of millennial generation collaboration preferences in a government agency. Samantha Sarley, open choice program, helping or hurting in the long run. Megan Kosala, school-wide positive behavior intervention and supports in a K-5 alternative education program. I would like to invite Dr. Sarah Ewell to the stage. Felicia Alexander, include culture, teachers' experience with culturally responsive teaching practices when working with African American students in special education. Aviva Ariel Aronovich, female entrepreneurs and grit, uncovering the common narratives across industries and life stages. Raina Friedman, walking the gangplank of professional learning, a case study of veteran elementary educators' digital professional learning needs. Congrats, Raina. Michael Lee Potter, the concurrence of colleges and universities conferring baccalaureate degrees, a case study of Washington State. Joseph Philip Humphrey, the impact on special education personnel when provided with training and a model of instruction to teach self-determination skills to students with ASD. Sophia Angela Russell, preparing graduate learners, a narrative study investigating the social learning environment of online education from the perspective of South Florida graduate students majoring in education who have immigrated to the United States. Congratulations. Lucy Stamp, neurodivergent learners, career identity development, a narrative study investigating the lived experiences of a cohort of neurodivergent learners. Laura Tamagini, the transformative impact of inclusive pedagogical practice in the middle school music classroom. Erica Vega, an exploration of the role of student leadership in the persistence, retention, and graduation of Latina community college students. Christoph Zaba, what is it like to be a pathway student? Voices of undergraduate international students at a large public university in New England. I would like to invite Dr. Karen Reese-Medwet to the stage. Caitlin Marie Goodington, building community capacity, a social support ecosystem for educators. Congratulations, Caitlin. Suhong Sharon Goh, exploring leadership pathways for China-born faculty in American higher education. Patty Kilbansky, Internarratives of Itinerant Art Teachers, Feelings of Connectedness and Professional Learning. Tanya Glenn Butler, The Role of Culturally Relevant Pedagogy Perceived by High-Achieving African-American Students. Laura Haug, Effects of Experiential Learning Towards Preparing for College and Career. Michael Andrew Pinnock, Any Port in a Storm, How African-American Men Use Relationships to Navigate Corporate America. Thank you, Dr. Reese Medwin. Congratulations to Northeastern's newest doctorates. Dean Fields will now announce the 2021 recipient for the Dean's Medal for Outstanding Doctoral Work. It is the highest honor awarded by the College of Professional Studies to a doctoral student.
This award honors exceptional academic achievement and recognizes the author's innovation and creativity, the scope and importance of the doctoral work to a field of study, and the caliber of the author's writing. I'm pleased to announce that the 2021 winner of the Dean's Medal is Dr. Michael Urmeneta, a graduate of the Doctor of Education program. Dr. Urmeneta's dissertation, Seeing the Unseen, an Action Research Study of First-Generation College Student Persistence at a Mid-Sized Private Institution in the Northeast, demonstrates his passion to serve students by helping higher educational institutions move the needle with an agile and collaborative approach to research and analysis. Dr. Urmeneta examined whether establishing a series of targeted interventions could increase a sense of belonging and persistence for first-generation college students at a mid-sized private institution in the Northeast. His research showed that targeted interventions, in this case, an event series, a resource website, and a communications campaign, could indeed impact a sense of belonging, positive engagement, and increased involvement among first-generation students, and that robust programming can occur even in resource-constrained environments and despite the challenges of a global pandemic. According to the chair of his dissertation committee, Dr. Joseph McNabb, professor of the practice, Dr. Urmeneta has done exceptional work throughout his doctoral studies. His creativity and his insights in investigating and improving the lives of first-generation students at his research site are exemplary. His dissertation in practice possesses a logical, organized flow of well-documented ideas. It is a model of scholarship, research, collaborative leadership, and advocacy. For over 25 years, Dr. Urmeneta has worked with academic institutions, leading institutional effectiveness, analytics, and student success initiatives. Congratulations, Dr. Urmeneta.
Dean Fields, Provost Madigan, faculty and administration of Northeastern University, family and friends, thank you. It has been quite a journey, particularly these last 20 months, this last 20-month stretch. But here we are, and we need to acknowledge that. We need to celebrate that. So if you'll indulge me for a brief moment, close your eyes, and silently think of the people who helped get you here today. Take a moment in gratitude. This is a journey that could not have been made without those who have paved the way before us and those who have walked the path with us. So to my parents, for whom this research is dedicated, and to my committee, Dr. Joe McNabb, Dr. Kim Nolan, Dr. Heather Kelly, thank you for lighting the path, and thank you for paving the way. And to my family, and to you fellow scholars, thank you for walking this path with me. I can think of no better traveling companions. Kathy and Emily, I don't know where you are, but there is no conceivable way that I could have made this without your love and support. You have my whole heart. My research is with first-generation college students, people who are the first in their families to go to college. They are the trailblazers in their families. They are the first. As such, they are people who often felt alone as they were navigating new surroundings. That's a familiar feeling. My hope with this work was to shine a light on this population, show that even little actions can have effect, remind everyone that change agents can come from anywhere, inside or outside the organization, and to do my small part to clear a path. So at the conclusion of my study, I was happy to discover that target interventions do work and that it could increase sense of belonging for first-generation students. And I was further inspired to know that robust programming can occur even in resource-constrained environments, despite adverse conditions, despite a global pandemic. Money was not the key factor in this. The key factor was people's desire to help, to walk the path of these students. Our degrees are conferred with the honors, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. I've had some time to think about these words. Honors and privileges are bestowed upon us. Responsibilities are how we give back to the world. Maya Angelou was mentioned earlier. I once attended a talk of hers where she said, "It is one thing to be trained, it is a whole other thing to be educated. And if you do succeed in becoming educated, to what end? To what end?" People talk about journeys coming full circle. That's one way to look at it. We go forth, we explore, we reach a milestone, and then we come back. But it's more than that. It's more like we arrive at a higher level on a spiral. We have the benefit of a little more altitude, a little more perspective. We have a better view so we can help those who come after us. So lean into that, own it. You've already cleared a path for those who come after. Continue to help light it, continue to help guide people on it, and continue to pave the way. Speak about your work, write about your work, collaborate with others around your work. Because in this fractured world, we could use a little light and a little more guidance. We could also use some company. Journeys are better together. Sometimes you need good people to tell you if you're veering off course. If left to my own devices, I'd still be writing this dissertation. And to be honest, if left to my own devices, I'd still be writing the application essay. I needed people to remind me of where I was going. As good as it was traveling with you, it's even better celebrating with you. So let's celebrate and get some well-earned rest. But after you've celebrated, after you've rested, here's some food for thought, items for your consideration, an invitation, or a challenge, if you will. If you still have that travel itch, find a moment and take a look at the limitations section of your studies, your areas yet to be examined, your recommendations for future research. Then take a look at this afternoon's program. It's online, you can find it. And consider that someone here has spent the same number of years examining your issue, their issue, as you did yours. And perhaps they might have that missing puzzle piece. Perhaps they may have that missing section of the map. And perhaps your next great collaborator and traveling companion is already in this room. Take both of those things and reach out and think about the next leg of the journey. I've already circled some of your names, so expect a call or an email. And so, my fellow scholars, this leg of the journey has come to a close. Today, we celebrate. Tomorrow, we get back on the road. I couldn't be prouder to be part of this group. Congratulations again, and I'll see you out there.
Congratulations again, Dr. Urmaneta, and to all of our newest doctorate holders. Doctors, on behalf of the entire academic team, your faculty and administrators, we want you to know how happy we are to celebrate this day with you. You have achieved something remarkable, and we are so proud to celebrate. Thank you all for being here, and again, congratulations to Northeastern University's newest doctorates. I'd like to welcome back the provost.
Thank you, Dean Fields. So I was just sitting there, I was remembering when my oldest kid was about 10, he had discovered there was these things called universities, and he was asking about degrees, and I said, well, there's bachelor's degrees, and then after that, maybe you could get a master's degree, and after that, maybe you could get a doctorate. And he said to me, which one do you have, Dad? And I remember saying, oh, I have a doctorate, and he went, wow. It just sticks in my memory, so you should be very proud of what you've accomplished and for getting to this point. Thank you, Dean Fields. You are our newest Northeastern doctorates. The world is ever changing. You are prepared to meet and conquer its challenges. You've made sacrifices, personal and professional, many of them, that speak to your drive, your dedication, and sense of purpose. Your love of learning has carried you to this day, propelling you to a life of achievement and fulfillment. Indeed, be proud. Know that what you have accomplished in these difficult times is nothing short of extraordinary. Remember, Northeastern will always be there for you, wherever you are. Our newest doctors, I salute you. Congratulations.
Will all graduates and advisors remain seated and wait for Professors Caracoglia and Bassani to lead you in the recession? We ask that the audience remain seated until the graduates have recessed.